All right. LDMMAC, this is your boy Coach Sheldon Harris, and you're live on the Coach Sheldon Harris and Comments Sports Show Live. Okay, folks, you know, one of my subscribers, man, you know, he tell me never to say his name, and he don't want to be identified, so I'm cool with that. But, you know, sent me this, and, God, dog, it looks like the UFC, they're going to book Katlyn Chookagian versus Jessica I. Now, I'm going to tell you the reason why I'm very disgusted by this fight. First of all, this is easy work for Katlyn Chookagian. Easy work. Katlyn Chookagian definitely got more skill sets, definitely got the better ground game. This is easy work for Katlyn Chookagian, in my opinion. I'm disgusted by this because I don't like how the UFC, they've been handling Katlyn Chookagian. I'm not feeling that, man. I'm not feeling how they've been handling Katlyn. And it's not fair because, you know, this girl was on, an 8-fight win streak before she fought Liz Carmouche and lost a very tight split decision. A very tight split decision, which a lot of people and a lot of analysts thought that Katlyn Chookagian won that fight. But, you know, that's neither here nor there. But it's almost like, man, they don't want to give Katlyn these opportunities. Like, they offered Katlyn the opportunity to be the backup if Sarge Eubanks couldn't make weight. And they gave her that. But, you know, of course, then they changed the fight date. So now Sarge and Katlyn, you know, they got two garbage fights. I mean, Sarge already beat Roxanne Modafferi. That don't make sense at all. And then, you know, Katlyn Chookagian is fighting a lesser opponent. She's what, the number 9 ranked flyweight, which if she beats Jessica I, I mean, how much higher is that going to get her closer to a title shot? I don't think that beating Jessica I is going to give her a title shot. I don't believe that. The only people who stand to make out in this is Jessica I, really, if she can win. But I got Katlyn Chookagian winning this fight. Easy work. Easy work. But, you know, it's amazing why, you know, Katlyn Chookagian has done more than enough to prove herself. Okay, she's done. She's on a 3-fight win streak right now, and she took out a very tough veteran in Alexis Davis. Okay, she went in there, and she literally bodied up on Alexis Davis, showed Alexis Davis what was up, and that's just how it is. But for some reason, the UFC don't want to cut this girl any opportunities. You know, it just would have made more sense if she could have fought Sarge. And people saying, well, Coach, why you got Sarge ranked so high? I got her ranked high because Sarge actually, you know, was like, she was one of the lowest seeds. She was one of the lowest seeds in that tournament, and she came out and won. And also, you know, I don't disagree with Nico being ranked so high. And I didn't disagree with Nico being ranked at the time because, you know, she won a tough tournament. She was a champion. And I gave Nico her props because I know all the Nico fans are going to come to this video. Coach, you just give him Sarge prop because, you know, and you know all the stuff that y'all say. You know, y'all trying to prove me to be some kind of undercover racist or something. But you guys, you know, you know what it is. I've been giving Nico her props for winning a tough tournament. Now, I did say, though, that the toughest competition to me wasn't in the tough tournament. But, you know, they get her and Sarge get mad props for doing that because they were the people that was picked not to win or not to go that far in the tournament. So they get a lot of props, lots and lots and lots of props. But I agree. I think Sarge is a very good competitor, and I think Sarge definitely is formidable for anybody. I think Sarge is going to give anybody a tough time, even Valentina. Now, I ain't saying that she's more skillful than these people, but Sarge is going to make it a tough fight for anybody she fights. And I agree. I think that Katlyn Chookagian and Sarge Eubanks need to fight for a title eliminator. But you would think that, you know, people, I guess the matchmakers at the UFC could conceive that. But they're giving Sarge and Katlyn two garbage fights. Sarge is going to go in there. She's going to beat the hell out of Roxanne Modafferi again for the second time. She's going to go in there and beat Roxanne down, okay? Katlyn Chookagian, I mean, they should have had Roxanne and Jessica I fighting. They should have had them two fighting. That fight would have made more sense. I mean, the battle of the two people that's not ranked that high. Make them earn it. Make them earn it. What has Jessica done? Jessica had two mediocre wins. She had two mediocre wins. And, you know, Jessica got all this mouth and running her little racist mouth. So Jessica just doing all the talking in the world, okay? But she's not going to get past Katlyn Chookagian. If she do, yeah, so what? Still ain't giving her no props. But she ain't beating Chookagian. Chookagian is about their business, okay? And you know what? I'm supporting Katlyn Chookagian every chance I get. And I'm making videos because what's happening to Katlyn Chookagian is completely asinine. It's completely asinine. It's completely ludicrous. I told y'all the UFC been doing some effing up. The UFC been doing a lot of effing up lately. And it's just like it doesn't stop. It doesn't stop. I'm disgusted by this fight. I'm completely, totally, 100% disgusted by this fight. And you know, whoever did it, Nick Maynard, Sean Shelby, somebody need to slap the hell out of them guys for putting this fight together. Somebody need to go slap Dana White in the back of his bald ass head. Somebody need to do something, man. Because there is no way with everything Katlyn Chookagian doing. Like, how the hell is Jessica Race's eye? How does she get an opportunity to fight the number three ranked flyweight? How does she get that opportunity after two mediocre wins? And then after a career of losing when she was in, the bantamweight division? I mean, see, this is what I mean. There's certain people, they just love to death, and they just keep giving these people opportunity after opportunity for what? They ain't doing PG-13. They ain't doing a darn thing but losing. Or doing just half as much. Man, okay. Well, you know what? I hope that, you know, Jessica and Sarge are both victorious. I hope they are. I'm sorry. I hope, not Jessica. I'm sorry. I hope Katlyn Chookagian and Sarge are both victorious. So there can be a showdown between Katlyn and Sarge. I think that just makes sense. It just makes so much more sense. Sarge and Katlyn been getting jerked around, man. They're getting jerked around and jerked around and jerked around. And it's like, okay. Now, I don't care about Jessica getting jerked around. I don't care nothing about Jessica. But I'm saying I'm talking about two people that's relevant. Two people that's actually relevant in the flyweight division. Okay? They're getting jerked around, man. And that's to a point where the UFC really just don't care. Don't give a damn about them. And these two people, and I'm talking Sarge and Katlyn, that is, you know, they're willing to do anything they can. They'll fight anybody. They'll take short notice fights. They're ready to step in if somebody can't show. Like, these are people you want in your company. These are people that are going to do the job. And these are people that are going to do everything they can to make good fights. They're going to do that. But they still get crapped on. So I'm not happy about this fight. I got Katlyn Chookagian by a massacre. I'm done. What are you waiting on? Subscribe to the best women's MMA platform on YouTube.